You've got a free ticket to a stadium event where 80% of the people you know are currently, and they will be staying indefinitely. Your kids are there, so are your best friends, your business colleagues, and your grandma. At this event, everyone stays in their own chair at first. Some never move from it. Some sit there with their arms folded and disengage. More move down an aisle when they see a couple of people they know, but they stay in their own clique. Similar to high school, they don't let anyone else in. Some are like hot dog vendors. They come by the seat, interrupt the conversation, and feature dump their product and leave, only to return every 5 minutes and do the same thing. Then there are those who know how to work the crowd and make everyone in their presence feel welcome. They learn everything about them, striking up a conversation, which pays off for them. Everyone loves them. You might convince yourself that you don't have to be at this event, so you refuse, mostly based on spite. You're not a lemming, so you're not going to attend. Those people are crazy. They'll come to you after the fad has died down, and then you can say, "I told you so." You'll soon discover almost everyone you used to hang out with is still at the stadium, having the time of their lives. They're getting real business done, too. However, you still refuse to go, citing all the evils that could happen because of what you heard through trusted news sources who are also not at the event. Time moves on, and you kind of miss those connections. They're not staying in touch. Nobody picks up the phone anymore. You're starting to feel like an outsider peering in the window and seeing everyone have a grand time at this event. They have no intention of leaving their seats. Even if the power suddenly shuts down and leaves them in the dark, they stay waiting until the next light. More and more people come through the turnstiles into the stadium. They stay like everyone else. You are having even more difficulty trying to reach people. You find a few others who are like you and not at the event or not online. You arrange a meetup with them and complain about what's happened. Nobody is engaging. Nobody connects anymore. People live online and don't talk to people anymore. The world has gone mad. Nobody younger than 30 has ever lived without a personal computer. People who grew up with rotary phones, party lines, the Beatles, and Led Zeppelin in their prime sometimes forget that every generation past 1981 was raised with technology. The following launch dates put this statement into perspective. In 1969, the internet is born. 1971, the first email is sent. 1980, cable news launches. The Cold War is over. John Lennon is killed. Nintendo is born. 1981, IBM markets the first personal computer to the masses. Space exploration takes off. Vehicle manufacturers introduce front-wheel drive and fuel injection. 1983, the first cell phone reaches the marketplace. 1989, the World Wide Web brings the world together electronically, and the MP3 launches a new era for music.